فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الحج حج محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sending his praise and salutations upon the final prophet and messenger, and starting with the khutbah al-hajj, the sermon of need, to proceed. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today I want you to think about something and take advice and remembrance and a warning. And that is with regards to the trials and the problems and the temptations. In Arabic, we call this fitan. Everything which is of evilness, falsehood, problems and calamities, oppression and persecution, whatever you see around today, existed in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. And sometimes the situation may be overwhelming and overbearing. We think it may be too much for us to bear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْفَرُ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And Allah has full power and control over his affairs, but most of men know not. Brothers and sisters, today we see amongst the Muslims all kinds of evil, all kinds of haram, all kinds of transgression against Allah's laws and limits. We see Muslim versus Muslim, brother against brother, sister against sister, son against father, daughter against mother, and to top it off, non-Muslim against Muslim. We see acts of cheating, lying, fraud, swindling out of each other's inheritance or land or wealth. We see people who are committing zina, adultery, fawahish, illegal sexual acts, and all other manners of crossing against the limits set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet even in this situation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from amongst these people, from between the people, Allah subhanahu has chosen and protected some of the humans, some of the believers, from such trials and temptations because they preserve the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are those people who do not fit into society today because they don't follow the crowd. They are the ones who stay away from cheating and lying and slandering and backbiting and fraudulent activity. These are the ones who protect their bodies, their modesty from doing haram. These are the ones that you do not find attending mixed gatherings. These are the ones you do not find, like the others, men who talk flirtatiously with women and women flirting with men. These are the people who, when they are invited to do sin, they stay far away from it and protect themselves from it. Who are they? They are the ones whom the Prophet ﷺ made a clear reference to when he said, إِنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ بَدَعَ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا فَطُوبَ الْغُرَبَىٰ. When the companions, when he said to his companions ﷺ that indeed Islam, it started as a stranger and it will return as a stranger. So give glad tidings to the strangers. And the companions, they asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are they, O Messenger of Allah? And he told them, those who correct what the people have corrected. Those who correct what the people have corrected. Here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say the righteous ones, because righteous itself is not enough. They are those who call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the ones who reform others and they don't give up to the corrupt reality of what is around them and give in to their urges and their desires. And they are the ones who are few in number. They are the ones whom he named Al-Ghuraba, the strangers. Muslims amongst non-Muslims, they are the strangers. Those who are the Muslims practicing amongst the non-Muslim, non-practicing Muslims, they are the strangers, the Ghuraba. And from amongst the people of knowledge, as opposed to the people of ignorance, they are the Ghuraba, the strangers. And from the people of knowledge, those who follow the Quran and Sunnah with the correct guidance, correctly, they are from the Ghuraba. They are the people who are distinct in their knowledge because they act on their knowledge to stay away from their innovations and desires. They are the ones who are patient against the ones trying to harm them. Those are the Ghuraba, the strangers. These are the true people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Ghuraba, the strangers. And because they don't fit the mainstream Society, the masses, they don't fit between them. They might be ridiculed. They might be mocked. They might be insulted. Subhanallah. This is no different to what happened to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And they may see you as extremists or as members of fringe societies. Why? Because you do not make people happy over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you seek only to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Humul ghuraba. Those are the ghuraba. Do you think such people, though they not may not be accepted by the mainstream masses, do you think they are sad or miserable? By Allah, they are not. Rather, they're the happiest of people. And why not? Did the Prophet ﷺ say to them, فَطُوبَى لِلْغُرَبَى. Or what is tuba? Tuba is derived from the Arabic word طيب, which means something which is good or happiness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran where he says,
الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ طُوبَى لَهُمْ وَحُسْنُ مَآبٍ.
Those who believe and do righteous actions, طُوبَى for them is a tree. This is a tree in paradise. طُوبَى is for them and a beautiful place of final return. This tree has a size of 100 years traveling by horse. It is a tree in paradise from which the flowers, its outer petals, the clothes that people of paradise are made from. Allahumma la tahrimna khayran ma indak bi aswa'i ma indana. Oh Allah, do not forbid us of your goodness, of your rewards, because of the evil from amongst us. Brothers and sisters, I want you to think about something. If a young man today, or a young woman, changes their lifestyle from what was evil and disobedience to Allah to somebody becoming righteous, how do you think that people will react? Sadly, they became strangers. Strangers to their old friends and their own habits. And sadly, even strangers to members of their family. For you'll see them react. They may say, oh, now you became bin sheikh, or you became Maulvi, or you'll say you became an extremist, you put the hijab on, you don't want to dress in fashion, you became like an old woman, covering head to toe. And if Allah increased her iman, she completely veils. Subhanallah. We don't need non-Muslims to insult us today. We do it to ourselves. But brothers and sisters, today, if you are the one making the change, then I give you glad tidings on behalf of our Prophet ﷺ, as he said, فَطُوبَى لِلْغُرَبَى. That tree in Jannah is for you, for your strangeness. Take comfort in these words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He left for you and I when he said, "Inna min waraikum ayyam as-sabr lil-mutamassiki fihinna yawma idhin bima antum alayhi ajru 50 minkum." And there indeed, ahead of you are days that require patience. Great patience requires. Whoever is patient during these days, from them will have the reward of 50 men of what he is doing. And the companions asked, O Messenger of Allah, the reward of 50 of those with him? He said, no, the reward of 50 of you. 50 companions' rewards is your reward for your patience in these times, O brothers and sisters. Imam al-Auza'i, he said, regarding the hadith that Islam became as a stranger, and referred to being a stranger, that he said, Islam will not go, but the people of Sunnah will go, until there will be none left except one man. And Yunus ibn Ubayd, rahimahullah, he said, there's nothing stranger than the sunnah. And what is stranger is he who knows it, follows it, and applies it. And Ibn Rajab, the great scholar, he said, these strangers are two kinds. One of them is the one who reforms himself when people are corrupt. And the other, and this is the lower in rank. And the second is he who corrects what people have corrupted, that he is active in removing the evil or changing the evil with his hands. If he can't do with his hands, then he does with his tongue. And if he can't do that, then he hates it in his heart. Al-Hassan, rahimahullah, said, a believer in this world like a stranger. He doesn't become anxious by its loneliness. He doesn't compete for its honor. Why? Because he's in a state and people are in another state. Today, we see the signs of strangeness if we open our eyes. What is the strangeness we have today, brothers and sisters? Strangeness in aqeedah, or some belief and creed. Those who hold on to the aqeedah of the pious predecessors, the Salaf al-Salih, the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, the Tabi'een, the first few generations, whoever holds on to their sunnah and their aqeedah, those are the strangers. Those who stick to what Allah has prescribed by the sharia and avoid what Allah has made haram, those are the strangers. Those people who pray the daily prayers, and they are few, as opposed to those who are heedless with the salah. Those are the strangers who stick to the laws of Allah and His commandments. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. It draws near for mankind their reckoning while they turn away in heedlessness. Strangeness today is in manners and conduct. Few are the people who have exemplary, excellent manners, but many are the ones with filthy language, with insulting behavior and insulting words. And that includes a son or a daughter who scream and shout and insult their parents when speaking to them as if the parents were their slaves or their servants. Allah musta'an. Strange are the numbers of Muslims who are actively practicing Islam, both through appearance and through their actions. Good examples, brothers and sisters, today have become strange. So how do we expect to affect others' behaviors if we ourselves have lost our good manners and our values? Strangeness is the ideology of Islam, which calls for the prohibiting of haram and the enjoining of good. Strangeness today is the ideology of al-wala wal-bara, loving and hating for the sake of Allah, which was what the Prophet ﷺ and his companions did. Strangers today, those who stick to that ideology and apply it. It's as if today, sadly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not revealed his ayat. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, la tattakhidhu aduwi wa aduwakum awliya'a tulquna ilayhim bil mawaddati wa qad kafaru bima ja'akum min al-haq. Oh, you believe, do not take my enemies and your enemies, being the disbelievers, as your close friends, showing affection towards them whilst they have disbelieved in what you have come with of the truth. Brothers and sisters, this is the situation of the ghuraba. They are indeed the strange ones. And I ask you to ask yourselves, am I lucky to be amongst the ghuraba, the strangers? Subhanakallah wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin was salatu was salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa ba'd. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah commented on the hadith, innal islam bala ghariba wa sayaud ghariba fatuba lil ghuraba. Islam came or started off as a stranger and will return as a stranger, so give glad tidings to the strangers. And he said that when Islam appeared as a stranger, it was because it was not well known. It was not known in the actions. This was a religion of Tawheed, abandonment of shirk, worship of Allah. And that's how it was known. And he said it will return again, like how it came in the beginning, but it will appear and be strong again. Brothers and sisters, don't misunderstand the hadith as some people do, thinking that this is a time of difficulty and Islam is strange, it will be difficult just to follow the religion of Islam, causing people to despair. No, this is a false understanding. Islam will return as a stranger, as it started by the will of Allah, and it will return even stronger as it did in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Allah's decree, verily it is I and my messengers who shall be the victorious. Indeed, Allah is all-powerful, almighty. Brothers and sisters, be aware that when you become one of the ghuraba, one of the strangers, then be ready for people to insult you and to mock you. And know that the path that you've chosen to follow is the path none other than that of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, and take comfort by these words, O brothers and sisters, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي يقاتلون على الحق يقاتلون على الحق ظاهرين لا يضرهم من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله. that there will always be a group of my ummah fighting upon the truth, having the upper hand and not harmed by their opponents until the decree of Allah comes, being the last hour. Brothers and sisters, no matter what is thrown at us for what we do of practicing our deen and defending it, be assured that victory is from Allah for Islam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised it.
هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون.
It is he who was sent, his messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with guidance and the religion of truth, to make it superior over all religions, even though the disbelievers hate it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ.
Allah has promised those amongst you believe and do righteous actions that He'll certainly grant them succession, meaning give them authority over the rulers of the earth, as He granted it to them, those before them.
وَلْيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا.
And He will grant them the authority to practice their religion, which is chosen for them in Islam, and He will surely give them in exchange a safe security after their fear, provided that they worship Me alone and do not make partners with Me in worship. So brothers and sisters, be accepting and be ready of whatever happens you, adversity or problems and calamities, for sticking to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it be at work, whether it be in your neighborhood, whether it be with your friends and families. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written those things for you as a test. So be firm, my brothers and sisters. Don't give in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ألف لام ميم.
ألف لام ميم. Only Allah knows the meaning of these letters.
أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون.
Do people think just because they say that we believe, they will not be left alone through trials, not be tested?
وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ.
And we indeed tested those before them.
وَفَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ.
And Allah will make it known the truth of those who are truthful and the falsehood of those who belie this message. So brothers and sisters, as I end here, life is short. Don't make it your goal that you exist in this world forever, because that life is nothing except a twinkling of an eye in the space of time that Allah swears by. And here I leave you with two advices. One is an ayah of the Quran, and the other is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, so that you may think deeply over them. Not only think, but you let it touch your hearts. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they not only touch your hearts, but they make you affected by them, that you change your life to be amongst al-ghuraba, the strangers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed when He talked about Musa alayhi salam, how He spoke to His people.
Ya qawmi innama hadhihi dunya mata'un wa innal akhirah. وَإِنَّ الْآخِرَةَ هِيَ دَارُ الْقَرَارِ.
O my people, truly the life of this world is nothing but a quick passing enjoyment. And indeed, the hereafter, that is the home that will remain forever. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said,
كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبَ وَعَالُ السَّبِيلِ.
Be in this world as if you were a stranger, or if you were just a traveler passing through. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who stick by the commandments of Allah, those who obey Him, not disobey Him, and those who obey Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and those who are guided rightly to the truth, those who stick to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are patient in the face of adversity, of trials and afflictions. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسي وثنى فيه بملائكته إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة الأكرمين وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم اهدنا لأحسن الأخلاق فإنه لا يهدي لأحسنها إلا أنت اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم اشمل بعفوك وغفرانك ورحمتك آباءنا وأمهاتنا وجميع أرحامنا ومن كان له فضل علينا اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كل عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه ما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا وما لم نعلم اللهم إنا نسألك مما سألك منه عبادك الصالحون ونستعيذ بك مما استعاذ منه عبادك الصالحون ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اذكر الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعم يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما يصنعون والله يعلم ما تصنعون وقوموا لصلاتكم استغفر الله العظيم